You have already seen our first video, what is a smart logger? Then it's time to have a first glance on our smart logger hardware. We will start in just a second. Welcome to episode 2 of our smart logger series. My name is Stephan. We will show you the hardware step by step and I will explain you the different parts in detail. Every logging project is different. In order to cover your application area exactly, we bundle the components fitting your use case in a smart logger package. As you remember from our first video, the VP6450 is our all-rounder. It's delivered in a package with a power supply, a power adapter, as well as a power cable, an ignition cable, two Ethernet cables, a GNSS antenna, two Wi-Fi antennas, and two vector bus interface cables. The package is completed by a quick start guide with links to the driver downloads and a USB flash drive with manuals. That's all you need to get started. The VP6450 has 6 classic bus channels. 4 channels are predefined as CAN, CAN-FD. Depending on your use case, you can order CAN, CAN-FD or LIN on the remaining 2 channels. The exchangeable storage cartridge is available with 4 or 8 terabyte capacity. There are 2 10 gigabit, 2 1 gigabit Ethernet and 3 USB 3.1 ports to connect a whole bunch of devices. Use the management port to connect your configuration computer. The VP6450 is easily stackable with our hardware interfaces VN5650 and VN1670. On the back side, you will find several ports. Use the GNSS port to connect an antenna, for example, to track the GPS position or refer your measurement data to the global UTC time. You have 2 ports to connect the Wi-Fi antennas. Connect your wireless devices with your smart logger's Wi-Fi. With our browser-based mobile UI, you can monitor the logging process. Now we are already at the last important interface, the power supply. The smart logger can be operated in vehicles or laboratories. If you are using the logger in vehicles, the delivered power cable is used to connect directly to the vehicle's power supply. The smart logger can only be started or shut down via ignition. To do this, please connect the cable on the sync port of the logger and your ignition line in the vehicle. In the laboratory, optionally, the 24-volt power supply can be used. If you don't have an ignition line available, the power minifit adapter can be used to connect the ignition cable to the logger. Now it's time to set up your smart logger. In the next video, I want to show you the initial configuration and then you are ready for your first data logging mission. If you like to learn more about smart loggers, check out our smart logger playlist. Leave us your feedback in the comments if you enjoyed this video. Thanks a lot and see you soon.